Many of you may or may not heard about New Life and what we're all about. So I just want to say thank you to Mr. Moss for inviting me here to speak to you briefly. We come from a natural perspective, and I think it's important to have a say. I don't believe we have the answer to everything, but I believe we do have something to offer in regards to healing. There are many different modalities and vernaculars of healing. And you know, sometimes we get confusing sometimes hearing different rumors with regards to healing. And so I bring, you know, the kind of a natural perspective, being that I was born and raised in Dubai, Kilalan. We call it Dao's Kilalan. And I was born in a city. And you know, it's a pleasure to come from humble beginning to travel the world. Study herbology, botany, ethnobotany, the origin of plants and how it relates to the body, etc., etc. I'm also an author. I have a book that I just released called The Chronicles of Healing. And in the book, I've outlined some of the food that we should eat, food that we should not eat. Now, I was told that amongst here are persons that are on the verge of retiring. That's correct. And so many of you here, I'm honored to be here just to speak to you because I know that you have contributed a lot to the Bahamas, to this country, and I think it's important that we recognize that, and I'd like to do my part, see how we could help you to enjoy the retirement or in the future years of your life, healthy and productive, you know, not enjoying your retirement on medication, you know, and the way to do that is to offer you a program or things that we do that brings you back to nature. Like me, you know, I climbed the tree to practice in Ghana. And I did two things one time by doing that. Natural, I got my exercise by climbing the tree. And then I got the natural fruits and herbs and spices that, you know, that the Most High ordained for us to eat. Now I was speaking to a gentleman in the back, and he was asking me about proteins and enzymes and different things when it comes to the diet. I told him that I don't know anything about that because I grew up amongst the goat. And the goat don't question the blade of grass and ask the grass, I wonder how much protein in this grass. You know, so we've become so educated that we've lost the touch with simplicity, the touch with nature. We've been severed. We sever that connection from nature. And so the message I bring today is that we need to reconnect to that which we once knew. This is my uncle here. And so you know what I'm talking about that lifestyle. And who here was not born on an island? I'm sure many of you know somebody that was born on an island or knew. Now, I just had a son born on the 27th. That's about 2 weeks ago. And when I went to the room to see him, the nurse told me that I had to wash my hand, and she told my wife that she had to wash her hand. She had to become sterile. And my mom put me in the corner and she said, come in. She said, you're born in the setting. And the midwife that brought you into the world read my placenta and that water burst on me. She said, you don't have to wash your hand because God made you sterile. This water, this fluid here for pretty. This is the sterilized body, so you're not going to contaminate the baby. But you see how we need to go back to nature like the goat? When the goat born the kid, the doctor don't intervene and say, hold on kid, don't suck that breast here. Let me sterilize that breast first. No, the goat, the kid wobbled to the breast and sucked the breast. And so my message today, again, is to reconnect. We need to reconnect. You see, we complexing things so much that we miss the simple things. So much so that when I say common sense things and simple things, people be like, wow, that's deep, man. Man, that's deep. My daddy said, what's so deep with that, man? You know, for example, I was on Jeff Lloyd last week, and I was speaking about a female that goes through 9 months gestation period, and when the baby is born. During those period, the female body makes certain preparation to facilitate this baby. A pregnant woman, body should not be an inconvenience. The child should not be an inconvenience for that female. She should not fall in a complication because if she's doing what she's supposed to do, the body is going to accommodate this baby in terms of breast is going to hurt you because it's preparing milk. And so when the baby's born now, this is what he said on the radio. Instead of sending the baby to the cow to feed the baby, we should use the milk that was developed over those 9 months period. And when he said that the cow do not send his baby to the human to feed it, everybody called the radio and said, wow, that's deep, baby. Man, that's deep. But what's so deep? I just said common sense. The breast milk is for the baby, right? But everybody's saying that's deep. So it shows you that we need to reconnect to that which we once knew. Now, there are some things that we are doing in our life today that do not compute with what God designed. Because there's a scripture in the Bible that lines up with what my company is all about. And we base the company based on biblical principle, which states that, number one, what I love, the herbs is for healing. There's also a scripture in Psalms 104, verse 14, that says, God made the grass to grow for the cattle, and he made the herbs for the service of humanity. He didn't say the white or the black or the pink or the yellow. He said for mankind. Now, if we were to ask ourselves, last 5, 10, 15 years back, were we being obedient to God? Were we using the herbs for the service of our body? Or were we doing something else? Were we tricking our body? What do I mean by that? Tricking the body. Well, like I told the gentleman in the back there, you would take steak. And they call it steak because when you eat it, your life is at steak. Like, you would take a piece of steak. You would take a piece of steak. And you can't eat that steak, unless you put something the body recognizes on that steak, which is herbs and spices. And if it ain't seasoned, you can tell your husband and your wife, man, honey, put some more salt on that, put some more lime on that, because you don't want to taste the blood in that meat. So you have to trick it, like a crackhead trick his body to release dopamine, to feel euphoria. So we have to trick our body to get that meat down. Now when we get the meat down, the body has to digest the meat. That's when we get important. You see? Now you can eat the herbs and the spices without the meat. But you can't eat the meat without the herbs and the spices. And that tells us that we're not supposed to eat it in the first place, because we have to go through all of that problem just to get that down. I'm telling you that you're setting yourself up for problem. You see, the meat eaters, the lion, don't cook his food. You ever see a goat with an apron on? Exactly. And so, okay, this is 2014 right now. And anybody that grew up in the year from 2000 to 14 years, from the year 2000 to the year 2014, everybody that grew up in that era know about diabetes, knows about hypertension, knows about cancer, knows about all of these different diseases by name, by function, by what it does, by symptoms, by everything. Knows about all of these different medications. But me, I was born in the 70s, and I was raised in the 80s and the 90s. And so when I was growing up, I didn't know nothing about diabetes, because I was raised up in Canada. I didn't know nothing about hypertension. But the kids today, they know everything about it. And we can't even imagine a world without it, without diabetes. All of us know somebody that's suffering from at least one disease, if we don't have it ourselves. And so, why? Why didn't I know about disease back then? And why is it that we know about disease today? And so, if back then, people were centurions, and today we're decadians, we live by the decades, we live to be 30, 40, 50, 60, be lucky, 70, be lucky, 80, be lucky. But it's a rare thing to see a centurion walking around, somebody that 100 years old. And back then, it was a normal thing to see somebody live 100 years. It was normal, you see? And so the question is, when that primitive, as we so call it, primitive, we were primitive back then. Because when I was growing up in Canada, there was no pharmacy. There still is no pharmacy there. The doctor came once every 4 months. There was no clinic. There was no nurses there. It was a midwife. My friend broke his leg in 2 places. He fought at the military. And his grandma took a splinter and taped it around his leg. And if you see him today, you'll never know his foot was broken. She never went to university for that. When I was a boy at age 6, I chopped my hand open with a cutlass trying to cut open a coconut. That would require somebody to be rushed to A&E to stitch it so it don't get infection. My grandma took some lard and a poultice with some herbs crushed up, and she tied it around that, and the next day it was healed. It never got infection. If I show you the scar today, it looked almost non-existent. She never went to university to study emergency medicine. She was connected like the goat. She was connected to nature, you see? And so, my question today is that, how come those centurions, who didn't know nothing but disease, how come they lived to be 100 years and up? With their primitive, without the hospital, without multi-million dollar machine, without chemotherapy, without early screening, without all of these medications and all these fancy diets and fancy restaurants, they lived primitive, but they lived to be centurions. But today, we have a wonderful hospital, wonderful machine. I call it bad luck machine. Bad luck machine. There was a lady that came to me and she showed me a receipt for $30,000. And she said she went to the States and she had a headache. And she went to IS. And see, that's another thing we didn't have on the island, IS. Everybody say IS. We didn't have IS. We didn't have oncologists. We didn't have dentists. We didn't have pharmacists. We didn't have specialists. We had FARM assist. FARM assist. Not THARM assist. You see, we didn't have IS up there. But this lady went to our IS. And he said, I'm a neurologist. And so he said, I'm going to charge you $1,000 a minute. And she spent 5 minutes and she spent $5,000 for him to tell her, well, let me send you to this next IS. Pay this $5,000 right here. And when she went to this next IS, she had to pay $9,000. She said, but I have this headache. And they sent me. It's excruciating, so they tell me I need to do this test. So he said, okay, pay this next $9,000 and stick your head in this machine. So she paid the next $9,000, she do like this. She stuck her head in the machine. So when she went back to get the results, he said, I have your results, but you have to pay me $9,000 and tell you what it said. So she paid the $9,000. I'm not even making this up. This is true. So before he quoted the results, she had to pay $9,000 and he came back and he said, you have a brain tumor. And she said, okay, well, what do you have to do? He said, let me send you to an S. He sent her to the S. And when she went to the S, he said, you have two things. Either you do nothing and you die, or we cut the tumor out and you may be a vegetable or you may die. That's the option. She spent all that money for bad news. So I call it bad news machine. Because it costs $1 billion. You have to spend all this money. But it falls short of diagnosing you. After they diagnose you, don't get me wrong now, they can look at every crease and crevice of your body. That's where it stops. Don't go no further. The body thrives on nutrition.